Amendment number 13, printed in Part B of House Report number 112-111, offered by Mr. Manzullo of Illinois.
Pursuant to House Resolution 316, the gentleman from Illinois, Mr. Manzullo, and a person and a member opposed, each will control 5 minutes. The gentleman from Illinois is recognized for 5 minutes.
Madam Chair, there are a lot of problems with this bill, as we have heard about already. In fact, on the wall of my office here in Washington, I have two pictures, among many. One is a picture of W. Edwards Deming and myself, taken just before he passed away in 1993, the real inventor of lean manufacturing. The other of Dr. Ray Demadian, the inventor of the MRI, who, when examining this legislation, said, if the new changes had taken place in the patent law, had they been part of the patent system when he invented the MRI never would have been invented. He knows more than anybody how flawed this bill is. I want to focus in particular on Section 10 of the bill, which allows the director of the patent office to set fees. I'm very concerned about this because in the last patent fight in 2004, when I chaired the House Small Business Committee, in return for supporting higher fees with reduced rate structure for small businesses, the provision in that bill allowing the PTO director to set fees was removed. This new bill abrogates that hard-won compromise and allows the director of the PTO to set the fees. It is not wise for the legislative branch to give up more power and authority to the executive branch. I know it's inconvenient to have Congress set fees, but that's the job of Congress, not the job of an unelected bureaucrat. When I chaired the House Small Business Committee, I continued the tradition of preventing the SBA from unilaterally being able to set fees to whatever level they sought. I don't see why we have to do this with the PTO. Now, in the present bill, Section 11 actually lowers fees for small business people and has a good patent fee structure. However, Section 10 would allow the PTO director to proceed with the administrative process to eviscerate that section and impose his own fees. To compound the problem, the patent office has been saying for years that if they had the authority to raise fees, they would. In 2002, the PTO strategic plan said they need to have a fee based upon a progressive system aimed at limiting applications. In 2010, the white paper on patent reform, they said the same thing. The patent office's idea of cutting back on the backlog is to raise fees. That doesn't make sense. But let's eliminate that authority from the patent office. Let's leave that authority with the United States Congress. Madam Chair, you don't strike a right balance between an inventor's constitutional right to file for an invention and giving a patent czar the authority to keep him out of the box by allowing him to raise the fees. Mr. Smith from Texas said it himself. He coupled patent backlog with the ability of the patent director to set the fees. That can only lead to one conclusion. They're going to raise the fees in order to cut down on the patent backlog. It doesn't make sense. This is the people's house. The patent office is the people's house for the little inventor. He must have every opportunity to exercise his constitutional right and file that patent. But if Congress cedes the authority to set those fees to a new authority of the patent director, and we can call him now the patent czar, that patent czar will control for 7 years at the minimum the flow of traffic coming through his office. And you know who gets slowed? You know who gets hurt? It's the little guy. And the purpose of my amendment is to protect the little guy, to make sure those fees are not raised, and also to make sure that the people in this country elect representatives in Congress, because it's our job to set the fees, not the fees of an unelected person, the person in charge of the patent office. I would therefore urge my colleagues to vote for the Manzullo Amendment to support the little inventor, to support the spirit of entrepreneurship in this country.